I am Sidra, and the topic of my today's presentation is tension headache. We have different types of headache, in which the most common is tension type headache. The tension type headache can be mild, it can be moderate, and it can be severe. We have two types of tension headache: episodic, that is infrequent, and chronic, that is frequent. Now, what are the causes? Causes include lack of sleep, stress, bad posture, depression or anxiety, and dehydration can also be the major factor. The signs and symptoms. The signs and symptoms include tightness, pressure, especially around neck and shoulders, severe head pain very commonly, sensitivity to loud noise is also there. The pathophysiology is that certain stress and stressful conditions or trauma activates the trigeminal nerves, leading to the release of neuropeptides, causing inflammation by nociceptor activation, mast cell degranulation, plasma protein extravasation, and vasodilation, overall resulting in headache or migraine. Now, the case we are going to discuss is of a 27-year-old female with recurrent headache that worsened when she started her job. It clearly indicates that her headache is associated with stress related to her job. Also, she has a history of stress-associated infrequent headaches. Plus, there are no GI and aura symptoms, indicating it is not migraine. Also, notice that aspirin and acetaminophen are no longer effective. Subject is 27-year-old female with history of infrequent headache. Her blood pressure is normal. Her neurological and physiological examinations are also normal. We have assessed that the patient is suffering from tension type headache. We do not have a 100% effective treatment for headaches. So, the goal of our therapy is the reduction in the frequency and the severity of the headache. Also, the management of comorbid conditions like stress and tension by pharmacological and non-pharmacological therapy. The non-pharmacological therapy includes good sleep, massage, hot bath, acupuncture can help, physical activities also play an important role, relaxation training, especially in stressful conditions, healthy lifestyle, and adequate intake of water is also very important. The pharmacotherapy include basically the pharmacotherapy of headaches include the use of aspirin and acetaminophen. Usually we start with aspirin and acetaminophen, but in this case both are not effective. So we started with NSAIDs, ibuprofen or naproxen. Ibuprofen in a dose of 400 mg Q4 to 6 hourly is recommended. Beside that, sedatives, anxiolytics, and skeletal muscle relaxants can also be given. For the management of tension and stress, amitriptyline is also recommended with the initial dose of 10 to 25 mg and then can increase with the maintenance dose of 50 mg per day. Course of therapy is about 3 to 4 months and depend upon the patient condition. Patient monitoring is very important, especially in case of analgesic abuse. As we know, analgesic abuse is very common in headache patient. So the drug should carefully be monitored, especially in case of opioid. Opioids can cause severe side effects when taken in abuse amount. This can also lead to chronic pain syndromes. The use of alcohol should also be completely restricted, as we see in the case that our patient is consuming alcohol. So it should be completely restricted as it can worsen the headache. With the use of antidepressants, particularly amitriptyline, the therapeutic index is very narrow. So the slight increase or decrease or up and down in the dose can cause serious side effects. So monitoring of the dose of antidepressants are very important. Thank you.